In this video, we define the common log, log of x, and the natural log, ln of x, and we do the following 8 problems. This is part 11 of Logarithms. We're going to begin with talking about what a common log and a natural log is. So, the common logarithm is base 10. What I mean by that, if we just write log of x, and you notice I don't write anything for the base, this is called the common log, and that just means log of x base 10. All right, so it's similar to using this square root symbol. You know when you put the cube root of, let's say, 64, that tells you what number cubed is 64 is 4. But if you just put the symbol like this, it means the square root of 64. We don't usually write the little 2 in there, right? So it's the same thing. When we use this radical symbol and we don't write a little number in there, it means the square root. It's the same thing with the logs. When you write a log and don't write the base, it always means base 10. And that's because we have a base 10 system, basically. All right, so if I say, what is the log of 100? I want to know what that equals. You have to know that the base is 10. And then you would think 10 to the what power equals 100. Can you figure that out in your head? That'll be 2. Now, of course, if you couldn't think of it in your head, you can go back to writing 100 as 10 squared and then use your rules that if this base is the same as that, you get a 2. In other words, 10 squared equals 10 squared. All right, let's do another one like that. How about log of 0.001? What's that going to equal? All right, that's a little bit trickier. Okay, remember, the base, even though you don't see it, is 10. And so the question is, 10 to the what power equals 0.001? Do you know what that would be? That would be negative 3. Now, if you're not sure how I got that, you can fool around with 0.001 if you don't know how to write that in scientific notation. But in scientific notation, it is 0.001 is written as 10 to the negative 3. So that's one way of doing it. And to figure that out, if you still have a little bit of trouble with it, you could write that as 0.001 means 1,000th. Okay? All right, now, what's 1,000th? Well, that's 1 over 10 cubed. Kind of write this 10 a little bigger. And then I could use my laws of exponents to write it as 10 to the negative 3. In any case, it's negative 3. And you should know when you see a 1 with zeros, you know, in it with a decimal here, you should be able to write it in scientific notation and figure that out. But if not, as you can see, there's other ways to eventually get the same answer. All right, well, the ones I gave you, it was easy. You could figure out what the exponent on 10 would be. But let's look at this. What's the log of 13? 10 to the what power equals 13? Well, that's a little bit tricky. You know it's not 1, because 10 to the first would be 10. And let's see, if it was 2, that'd be 100. 10 squared would be 100. So it's in between 1 and 2. So you could estimate this is going to be 1 point something. But the question is, how would you know what that is? Well, we could use a calculator. Now, all calculators are a little bit different. So it depends if you're using a graphing calculator or a scientific calculator. So in a scientific calculator, usually there's one or two ways to do it. You would enter the number first, then you would punch the log button. And if that doesn't work, you might also need to press the word enter. In mine, I don't need to do that. So in my calculator, if I push 13 and then you should see a log button, it comes up automatically that I'm going to get 1 point, I'm going to write it up here, 1.113945 43352, and that's not the exact answer, but that's as far as my calculator goes, so really this goes on and on and on. So if we were going to approximate this to four decimal point places, which is kind of where we usually estimate logs, four decimal places, let's see, if I rounded this would be one, all right, it's 394. Since I cut it off there, four, you're going to just keep it the same, so that's 39, and so it's approximately 1.1139. All right, so try this one in your calculator. How about the log of 6? See what you get. Right, in my calculator, I get 0.77815125. That's really goes on and on and on. And if I were going to go to, let's say again, four decimal places, this would be 0.77. Okay, I'm cutting it off after the one here, and that's a 5, the next one, so that's going to be 82. That would be rounded to four decimal places. Now, does that make sense? We're saying, does 10 to the 0.77 blah blah blah, does that equal 6? That's what really you're saying. Remember, the log is an exponent, right? The log of 6 is the exponent on 10 that equals 6. Well, 10 to the first power would be 10, and I only want to get 6, so it makes sense that this is less than 1. So that's why it came up 0.778, etc. So you can estimate and make sure that, it's reasonable. At least you know it's in between 0 and 1. All right, the other special log is log base e. First of all, what's e? You may not have heard of that before. E is an irrational number like pi that is very useful in math, and you'll see some uses soon. It's also very important in calculus. E is 2.71828182 dot dot dot. It does not repeat, even though you happen to see 1828 here twice in a row, then the next digits don't repeat. So it's approximately 2.7, just like we memorize pi to be approximately 3.14. All right, so ease this number, it's about 2.7, and the way we write the natural log is ln. So if you put ln of, let's say, 10, that means log base e of 10. So just like the common log, we don't write the 10, for the natural log, we don't write the e. So if you see log base e, the shortcut is to write ln. Now, in books, it usually isn't in script. I like writing in script so it doesn't look like the word in. All right, so again, we could use our calculator. So let's say we wanted to get the natural log of 10. So in my calculator, I'm going to put the 10 and then the ln button, and you might have to put enter. That's, you might have to use that button. So let's see, I'm going to put in 10, and I press ln, and it comes out 2.30258503, and of course, remember that goes on and on and on. And let's round that to four decimal places. What'll that be? 2.3026. Okay, now let's see if that makes sense. Log base e of 10 is approximately 2.3026. So what you're wondering is, that makes sense. Remember, e is about 2.7. It's about 3. Imagine, right? E is not quite 3. So kind of like 3 squared is 10. Yeah, it seems in the ballpark. Of course, hopefully it's right, because hopefully your calculator is computing it correctly. So this is the natural log. Try one more. How about the natural log of, let's say, 213? And how about approximating it to four decimal places? So go ahead and try that on your calculator. All right, I got 5.36, and it goes 129, so it's going to be 13. Okay. So that's about the common log and the natural log. Here are two quick problems for you to try. All right, natural log of e to the fifth. Remember, you don't have to write this out, but that means log base c of e to the fifth. So really, it's just the exponent here, using your laws of logs. And same thing here. This means log base c. Now what? Square root of e means e to the 1/2. So the answer is just 1/2. So if you've got the natural log, right, and you've got the base e, then it's the exponent is the answer.